Hello my dear students, in this video let us discuss the important topic related to the timber, which is defects in timber. Generally defects is irregularity or any sort of deformation which is actually not preferable, and also something what we do not require is called defected material, or it is said to defect, to be defected, or it has a defect. So timber is naturally available construction material, also a building material, and most vulnerable to get decay or to get affected with defect. So in this video we will discuss what are the different defects in timber and what are the causes for it in detail. Generally defects are likely to occur in timber with the following categories. There are five. We have around five categories, out of which defects are classified into based on the reasons or based on the causes of those agents which are causing the defects to take place. So we have first a defects due to natural forces, second defects due to conversion, and next a seasoning, and next fungi, and last defects due to insects. Due to these five reasons, so let's get into them in detail. So defects due to natural forces, there are many. The first one is defects due to natural forces. So based on this, the effect of natural forces, the timber defects are around seven. We have chemical stain, rindgals, shakes, upsets, twisted fibers, knots, and burls. So first we'll move on to the chemical stain. So as the word itself say, it is staining chemically, means it is if the wood getting affected or coming contact with any chemically, and if this chemical or chemical action will create on any stain of the wood surface, then we called it as chemical stain. Staining means discoloring, that is color of the surface gets changed. So the color of the wood on the surface of the wood is stained by the chemical action, then we'll call it as chemical staining. Next we have rindgals. So we observe in this diagram there are bulge portion. See, this is a bulge portion. Rind means a bark, gall means a swelling or normal growth. So abnormal growth or abnormal swelling that takes place on the bark of the tree is called rind gall. Where branches are improperly cut down at those places, and we can observe rindgals. Wood of these places is generally a weak. So next third in natural forces is shakes. Shakes are nothing but cracks, but covers completely or incompletely the wood structure. Cracks are generally longitudinal separations in wood between the annual rings. So in these shakes also we have various classification. Let's see them. One type of category is star shakes and cup shakes, heart shake, and also a ring shakes. So we'll discuss what is star shake. These cracks extends from the bark towards the sapwood, means come from outside to inside. You can see here we can see here there is a cut here and also here and also a crack here, so it looks like a star shape. Okay, so extends from bark to towards sapwood, so it's called a star shake. So next, what is cup shake? Generally we know annual rings which represent the age of a tree. Along the annual rings, these cup shakes occur. Okay, this is annual ring, you can see here. Along annual rings, these cup shakes occurs. And once we cut the cross section of tree, when we observe it, we can see a curved split like this, curved split around the annual rings. Means we see a cup like rings, we cannot see the smooth rings. We see a unequal growth of the rings, that's called the cup shake. So next, heart shake. Heart shakes means cracks originate from the medulla, that is the center part of the wood. From there the crack will originate and it will keep on extending up to the sapwood like this. So it will cover the medulla, the heartwood and the sapwood. So this sort of shakes are called heart shakes. Next, ring shakes. Ring shakes means they cover the entire ring, means they cover the entire annual ring. They'll cover entire the annual ring. They damage the entire annual ring. That's called as ring crack or ring shakes. Okay, next we'll move on to twisted fibers. Okay, after chemical stain, we discussed Rindgeld and also shakes. Next, we'll move on to twisted fibers and then we'll go on to the upsets. Okay. So, in twisted fibers, fibers of the woods get twisted. How? When tree is at an young age, when their parts of it growing, at that time if tree is subject to any injury or any sort of wind action, so the tree will get twisted. So the fibers of the tree will also get twisted. So it is called a twisted fiber. So next, upsets. Wooden fibers which are injured by crushing or compression is called upsets. If artificially or naturally or some one hits the wooden or a tree, some of the fibers may get damaged is called upsets. Someone hits the wooden or on a tree, some fibers may get damaged. That's called upsets. Okay, next, knots. What is knots? Small roots of tree or very small branches of tree is called knots. These knots may be alive or dead. But what happens is, these knots try to break the continuity of fibers, thereby forming a small knot-like structure. When this knot type of defect occurs, that can be easily detected by your naked eye. So in this diagram, we can see here. This is a live knot and this is a dead knot. So what we can observe is their fibers will come closer together and they form like small society. So that can be easily segregated from the remaining surface of the wood. With the naked eye, we can easily note the fibers which not be continuation, and there will be small or round in between. Next, defects due to conversion. So in the process of converting the timber to application purpose, some defects may happen like chip mark, diagonal grain, torn grain, vein. So let's see them in detail. First one, chip mark. It's a defect indicated by mark placed on finished surface of timber. So during the process of converting, if there are any marks like hammer marks, it will show some depression on the surface of wood. So that's called as chip mark. Next, diagonal grain. It is generally formed when wood is not cut properly or if it is not sawed properly. Means generally if we observe in the diagram, this part, the surface is not exact. Means when cutting wood with the help of the saw, sometimes saw may not happen properly. At that time, some grains are left over. Such type of damage is called diagonal grain. Next, torn grain. So any sharp instrument or any equipment falls on the timber, you can see in this diagram, any sharp instrument or any equipment falls on the timber, what will happen means some of the grains of the timber will cut off, they get damaged, they get torn away, and that is called torn grain. Next, vein. It's actually denoted by presence of virginal rounded surface like this, virginal rounded surface on the manufactured piece of a timber. So we'll move on to defects due to seasoning. Seasoning is a process of drying timber or removing moisture from the timber. During this process, we may have some defects like twist, cup, bow, and spring. So what is twisting? First one is twist. So twist means so during the seasoning process, wooden fibers may get slightly twisted. gets slightly twisted also. That's called twisting. Next, cup. Cup is exactly reverse of bow. Actually, I'll tell what is bow. Bow is curved shape element. So like that bow shape, timber will get a bow shape. So this one of the defect due to this seasoning. So cup is exactly reverse of the bow. A cup like curvature will come along the direction of the timber. So last, spring. Spring means the curvature of the piece of saw timber in the plane of its wide face, known as a crook, or it is called as free side bend. So next, defects due to fungi. The artifact fungi will result in the following defects in timber. We have blue stain, brown rot, dry rot, hot rot, wet rot, white rot. So what is blue stain? As a wood itself is tending, the staining is blue in color. Means the sapwood of the tree will change into bluish color due to the action of fungi. So what is brown rot? A brown rot is sometimes also called the disease. Why? Because some type of fungi, when they affect or when they attack the timber, they eat away all the cellulose from the wood, and hence wood turns brown color. That's called as brown rot, or it is also called as cubic rot. Next, white rot. This is just the reverse of the brown rot. That is, the fungi will eat away all the nutrients and cellulose from the wood. But what happens is the wood looks white in color, not brown. So I'll tell what is hot rot. So hot rot is again the defect which is formed by the attack of fungi at the heartwood. Heartwood means it is the part of the annual ring which are covering the medulla or the center part of the tree, which looks darker in color. So one can easily segregate heartwood and sapwood by the color, because heartwood looks more darker than sapwood. So fungi affects or attacks timber only up to the heartwood portion. That is called heartwood. So see here. So this is the complete heartwood portion, and there is complete defect here. That's called heartwood. Next, wet rot. So wet rot means the fungi starts decomposing the timber and they convert the timber into powder form. That's called wet rot. So next, white rot. I've explained just what is white rot. I'll tell what is dry rot. Not explained this one, a dry rot. Usually the fungi which are eating wood as their food, they keep always feeding on the food and they try to yield out dry powder. That's called as dry powder. So it is small difference between wet rot and dry rot. So in wet rot, the fungi will decompose the wood and it will convert the wood into grayish brown powder, whereas in the dry rot, they generally eat away the wood and give out the original powder or original color of the wood. That's called a dry rot. And last, defects due to insects. We have three types of agents which are causing this. We have first one beetles, next marine borers and termites. Coming to beetles, beetles are small insects and they are capable of making pinholes. You can see the small holes are made into the wood. You can see here. You can see in the third diagram here. Around 2 mm diameter, they can dig the holes and they try to give out or try to convert the standard wood into powder wood. Next we have the marine borers. These type of insects are generally observed in salt water. So, in wood construction in salt water or sea water, one has to be careful with these marine borers. So what they do is they make a holes into the wood just for taking shelter. So you can see bores. Bores means they are holes made by this. They are holes. Holes made by this. So that's why it is called marine borers. The holes may be around 25 mm diameter and 60 mm deep and 60 mm long. Imagine they make good amount of holes, thereby deteriorating the wood. So when the ships and boats move into salt water, one has to be careful with the marine borers. So last, defects caused by termites. Termites are also called as white ants. Once the wood is affected by termites, it is very impossible to take control. It does not take much time and they eat away the wood very, very fast. So they make tunnels inside the wood and they do not disturb the outer part. They just enter inside and start eating away the entire inside portion of the wood. You can see here, just out looks good, but once it is touched or physically when applies load, there will be nothing inside, like this in the third diagram, nothing inside. So completely the wood fails. Thank you very much.